In this video, you will learn how to define colors for drawings. Colors help in distinguishing different elements, such as parts, marks, and dimensions, making the drawings easier to understand. Colors are also important for controlling the line thickness of different elements when you print drawings. We will use a general arrangement drawing to illustrate how you can define colors. Adjust the colors on a drawing level, or use the detailed object level settings to achieve consistent output. You can color code the objects in your drawings by using standard colors or custom RGB colors. Defining and saving a set of custom colors enables easy reuse and sharing in a specific project. Let's start by looking at the drawing color modes. There are three different drawing color modes you can select from: black and white, Tekla grayscale, and color. You can manage custom color palettes from the Color Palette Editor. Here you can add new colors to an existing palette, edit or delete colors. You can also easily create a new color palette file. To maintain a high level of consistency, you can define the colors on the drawing level and enable them for objects. Let's look at a general arrangement drawing. Double-click the drawing's background to open its settings. Open Part Properties. If you want to change a color, you can access the standard colors from the drop-down menu or from the separate dialog. Select a color and click Modify. The line color of all the parts in the drawing is now changed. Use the detailed object level settings to simplify and automate the color assignment. First, create or load a settings file. Click OK. Turn on the Use Detailed Object Level Settings option. The colors and line thicknesses are automatically changed throughout the drawing to match the detailed object level settings. To fine-tune the colors of an object, you can also make changes at the individual object level. However, to ensure new drawings are created according to your specifications, configure the drawing and detailed object level settings first, because individual object level settings override them. Then, only change individual objects in the drawing when necessary. Let's change the color of a part mark. Select a custom color from the predefined color palette. Finally, let's look at defining colors and line thicknesses for printing. Load the predefined printing settings. You can select the color mode specifically for printing. The options are color, Tekla grayscale, and black and white. On the Line Properties tab, you can change individual output colors if you wish, including assigning a custom color to an object. The output preview shows you a preview of the line with the defined color and line thickness. You can also select several rows while holding down the Control or Shift key and change the output color or line thickness of several objects at once. You can use the default color and line thickness for those colors in the drawing that have no definition on the Line Properties tab. Using the By Object value for the default row enables all drawing colors without an entry in the list above to be printed, as they are defined in the drawing. With a single click, you can also add all object colors from the previewed drawing, making it easy to modify output colors and line thicknesses. If you want the drawing lines to be shown on the screen with a line thickness you defined for printing, enable the Printer Line Widths option in the drawing settings. By following these steps, you can effectively define and manage colors in your Tekla Structures drawings and make sure they are tailored to your project's needs.